Let's directly jump to a question. Let's directly jump to a question on this. A very simple one. Find the angle between the planes. 2x plus y minus 2x plus 3 equal to 0 and r dot 6i plus 3j plus 2k equal to 5.
So is it 2x minus 2x only over there?
Oh, it should be z over here. Just make this change. Typo. Don't make any silly mistake, guys. Please, that is the last thing that should happen to you. Losing marks because of silly mistake is very, very painful. Very, very painful. Let me tell you. Losing marks because not knowing a concept, that's fine. But losing marks despite knowing the concept, that's a terrible feeling. That's correct, Aditya. Okay, so just... The direction ratios of these two planes are indirectly mentioned to you, right? So let me call this plane as the plane pi 1. Let me call this plane as the pi 2 plane. So the direction ratios of pi 1 plane is going to be 2, 1, minus 2. And direction ratios of pi 2 plane is going to be 6, 3, and 2. Okay, now the angle between them, that is cos theta, let's say I want to find out the acute angle, that's a1, a2, that is 12 plus 3 minus 4 mod by under root of 2 square, 1 square minus 2 square, and under root of 6 square, 3 square, 2 square. Okay, now guys, 6, 3, 2, and 2, 1, minus 2 are very commonly used expressions in vectors because their mod comes out to be 3 and 7 respectively. So again, some people already know this, so they'll save a lot of time. So this becomes 11 by 21, that is 3 into 7. Okay, so your answer is cos inverse of 11 by 21. Can I move on now? Simple question. I wanted to give you one more question before taking this question. I think I skipped that one. Yeah. Please try this question, then I'll move on to another concept. Find the equation of a plane passing through 3, 4, minus 1 and parallel to this plane. Done?
30 seconds.
Okay, so see what is given to us that you have to find the equation of a plane passing through this which is parallel to this plane, right? Now, when two planes are parallel, it's very obvious that the normal to both the planes would be same, isn't it? So this normal would be the same to both the planes, correct? Yes or no? So what I can do is from this equation, I can borrow the normal. So the normal of the required plane, let's say this was my plane r dot 2i minus 3j plus 5k plus 7 equal to 0, right? So I can say that the normal for this also will be 2i minus 3j plus 5k. Or at least a scalar multiple of that. Correct. So I can say that my required equation would be r dot 2i minus 3j plus 5k. Okay. Equal to some constant, which is not 7 in this case. So some value you can write it. Let's say I call it as a value L. Okay. Now to find this value L only, you have been provided that the plane passes through 3, 4, minus 1. Correct? So we can put that over here. So instead of r, put 3i plus 4j minus k dot 2i minus 3j plus 5k equal to 1. Okay? So just open the dot product over here. It'll get 6 minus 12 minus 5 is equal to L. Is equal to L. So I think this gives you minus 11 as your L. Am I right? Yes or no? So put it back over here. So my final equation boils down to r dot 2i minus 3j plus 5k equal to minus 11 or plus 11 equal to 0. So this becomes your desired answer.
So, but can we take the normal to be same and not scalar multiple?
Does it matter though if you take it?
Yes, sir. I didn't take that r dot only.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. See, why it doesn't matter? Let me show you how. So let us say I had given you r dot, let's say 2 lambda I minus 3 lambda j, 5 lambda k, okay, equal to some constant, correct? Yes or no? So when you put the point here, you end up getting minus 11 lambda is equal to L, right? Correct? So when you put this back over here, you'll get minus 11 lambda. Drop lambda from everywhere now. You are back to the same equation which I got.
See, oh, is it because direction ratios are infinitely many, so it won't
Yes,
matter?
Yes. And see, normal can be from here, normal can be from here, normal can be from here, normal can be from here. Any point you trace, they're all parallel to each other, right? So normal doesn't mean it has to pass through the center of a plane. There's nothing like center of a plane or something. Normal is a plane is an infinitely extending geometrical figure. So any perpendicular to is a normal. Whether both the normals are parallel to each other, it doesn't matter to us.
Yes, sir.
Makes sense? Okay. Fine. So next we are going to talk about one of the very important concepts, which is called the concept of line of intersection. Line of intersection of two planes. In short form, I'll refer to it as LOI. Okay. So when two planes intersect, okay, when two planes intersect, they intersect on a line. So this red is line is called the line of intersection. This line is called the line of intersection. Okay. So many a times when we have to mention the equation of a line, they will just mention you the equation of the two planes and they say this is the line. For example, they'll say there's a line given by the equation x minus y plus 2z equal to 5 and 3x plus y plus z is equal to 6. Okay, let's say they'll give you like this. Okay, and many people, they get surprised. They say, hey, they have given the equation of two planes and they're claiming that it's a line equation. Yes, it is a line equation. All they mean to say is that the line is created by the intersection of these two planes. Are you getting my point? So mentioning such equations is called the asymmetric form of the equation of a line. This is called the asymmetric form of the equation of a line. So whatever we had learned was actually the symmetric form, that is x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. But this is called an asymmetric form. So don't be surprised in future if you see there is a line equation which is mentioned as the equation of two planes. Is just another way of writing the equation of a line, which is basically passing through the intersection of those two mentioned planes. Have I made myself clear? Okay. Now, what type of questions will you get? There are two types of question which is based on it. One is converting the asymmetrical form to symmetrical form. That's one type of question. And second type of question is there would be some information about a plane passing through the line of intersection, thereby giving it a family of plane concept. So we'll talk about the second concept a little later on. Let me first take a question where I have to convert a asymmetric form. Okay, let's take this as question itself. So this is an asymmetric form of a line. Tell me the symmetric form for it. Now, since you have not done any question of this type before, let me start with this question as a illustration problem. So when you want to find the equation of a line, what are the two things that you need? You need the direction. Any line, you need a point and you need a direction, right? Right? Without these two things, we'll not be able to get the equation of a line. Correct? Now, if you want to find a point, what do we do is we put any one of the three variables as zero in both the equations. Okay? So let's say I put z as zero in both the equations. So put z as zero in both the equations. So you'll end up getting x minus y is 5. And 3x plus y is equal to 6. Okay. So from here you can find out the value of x to be 11 by 4. Okay, put it in any one of them. Let's say I put in the first one. So y 11 by 4 minus y is 5. So y is equal to minus 9 by 4. Okay, so we have got a point on this line, which is 11 by 4 minus 9 by 4 and 0. Now people ask me, sir, could I put y also as 0? Yes, you can. Could I put x also as 0? Yes, you can. It's your call. Okay, so the point may be different for different people. Now here, a very important precaution to be exercised is that when you're putting any variable as 0, it should not lead to an inconsistent equations per se. Let me give you an example where such thing may arise. Let's say you had equation x plus y plus 2z equal to 5 and x plus y minus 3z equal to 6. Right? Let's say these are the two planes. And you decided to put x equal to 0. What will happen? It will lead to an inconsistent set of equations. Isn't it? One is saying x plus y is 5. Other is saying x plus y is 6. This is not possible. You cannot solve this, right? So refrain from choosing such points as 0, which will lead to inconsistency in your answer. It is just equation's way of saying that on that plane, z equal to 0 is not possible. Have I made myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Second thing is, people ask me, sir, is it necessary to put 0? Can't I put 1 or 2 or something? Yes, you can. You have full right to put any value to any point. But just that, whatever are the other two equations that are coming up should not lead to infinitely many solutions, or should not lead to inconsistent equations. Okay. Because we just need one point. So here we have got a point. So one task is over. Okay, so point is known now. How do I get the direction? To get the direction, it's very obvious that this line of intersection is simultaneously perpendicular to the normal of pi 2 and perpendicular to the normal of pi 1, isn't it? So let's say n1, n2 are the normal vectors. I'm sure you would all be able to appreciate that this is also perpendicular and this is also perpendicular.
So this line will lie on which plane?
Both the planes, my dear. Both the planes, pi 1 and pi 2. It is the line of intersection of both the planes. So think as if it is like your, the corner of your book, right? And the pages are your planes. Are you getting it? So the line of intersection lies on both the planes. It lies on both pi 1 and pi 2 plane. Correct? And at the same time, it is perpendicular to n1 and n2 also. Do you realize that? Of course, one implies the other. If it lies on pi 1, then n1 will be perpendicular to the line of intersection, right? If it lies on pi 2, n2 will also be perpendicular to the line of intersection. That means n1 and n2 both are perpendicular to the line of intersection. Is that clear? This is very important. Everybody, Ardhara, Hamsini, Likhit, is that clear? Yes, sir. Okay, fine. So if I know the normal to both the planes, I know n1, n2 vector, can I not find out the direction of the line? So what is the direction of the line here? You will say simple, it will be along the direction of n1 cross n2. Yes or no? Any vector which is simultaneously perpendicular to two vectors lies in the direction of their cross product. So n1 cross n2, you can find it I, j, k, 1, minus 1, 2, 3, 1, 1. Okay. So this is, okay, let me expand it. So it becomes minus 3, minus j, it becomes minus 5. Okay. And k will become 4. Am I right? K will become a 4. So it's minus 3i plus 5j plus 4k. So you can use this minus 3, 5 and 4 as your ABC of the line. So finally concluding, your equation of the line will look like this in symmetric form. X minus 11 by 4. See here, 11 by 4 was your point. Divided by minus 3 is equal to y plus 9 by 4 divided by 5. And z minus 0 by 4. This becomes your equation of a line. Okay, you can want, if you want, you can write it in a simpler form, 4x minus 11 by minus 3, 4y plus 9 by 5 is equal to z minus 0 by 1. Okay, this is your symmetric form. So I'll just repeat the procedure once again. What do we do to convert asymmetric form? What is an asymmetric form? Whenever you have been given the equation of a line by mentioning the two planes whose intersection generates that line, we call that equation to be an asymmetric form. So in order to convert it to symmetric form, you need the point and you need the direction of the line. To get a point, we put one of the variables as 0, 1, 2, whatever you feel like, but it should not make the system of equations inconsistent. Once you have found out the points, now you can find out the direction by taking the cross product of the normal vectors to both the planes. And once you know the direction, you can always write down the equation of a line. Does that make sense, everyone? If that makes sense, I will have to give you a question. Here you go. Find the angle between the lines. Now see here, there are four planes mentioned. In fact, there are two lines mentioned. This is your line number one, L1. And this is your line number two, L2. Right? And they're now asking you the angle between these two lines. Try it out. That's correct, Shreya. Anybody else? Shreya has already replied. Guys, hope you're not finding the complete equation because I just need the direction ratios of the two lines. So don't give me the symmetric form for both the lines. That is not required. Aditya? Nikhit, Ardhara, Hamsini, Samyukta.
I'm getting that the perpendicular.
Let me tell you, you are correct, Aditya. Okay. So all you need to do was get the direction ratios of the L1 line. So it's perpendicular to both the planes simultaneously. So let's write I, J, K, 1, minus 3. And there's no Z over here, right? So 0. Okay, and here there is no x, so 0, 4, minus 1. Okay, so when you expand it, it becomes 3, okay, minus j, minus 1, and k will give you a 4. So 3i plus j. And plus 4k. That's the direction ratios, you can say 3, 1, and 4. So for the direction ratios of the other line L2, again I have to do the same thing. I, J, K components are 1, 3, 0, and 0, 2, minus 1. Okay. So it's I minus 3. Minus j, minus 1, and k, 2. So it's minus 3i plus j plus 2k. Fine. So the direction ratios here are 3, minus 3, 1, and 2. So let us find out the angle by using the formula a1, a2, b1, b2, c1, c2 by under root of a1 square, b1 square, c1 square. But let me find the numerator first. So a1 a2 is minus 9 plus 1 plus 8. That itself becomes a 0. So no need to do any further. It implies L1 and L2 are perpendicular. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Okay.